What historical mystery is unlikely to ever be solved? The exact burial site of Genghis Khan. I watched a documentary about this on CuriosityStream a little while back. There's a good plausible possibility that Genghis Khan and a handful of his descendants were buried under a mound at the top of his favorite mountain, Burkhan Khaldun. He sheltered on that mountain after he had to run away as a child, and he declared it sacred. To this day, you need special permission by the government to even get close to it. It was very interesting. The murder of Olaf Palme. The official version doesn't have any real evidence or any murder weapon. I love the crime trilogy around that topic by Leith G.W. Person. What caused the Bronze Age collapse? Probably oxidization. Noise. Whatever happened to the Sodder children? There are too many unsolved cases involving children. The Beaumont children are the main ones in Australia, though a few years later two young girls were kidnapped from Adelaide Oval, possibly by the same person, though we'll never know for sure. The most likely suspect is dead. What Pope Leo said to Attila the Hun? Attila was taking over the world and made it to Rome and the Vatican. Leo rode out alone and spoke to Attila and convinced Attila to not destroy Rome and the Vatican. What was said? Only the archives of the Vatican has any idea. OMG, can you like, not? I never thought about it that way. If Bethesda rewrote history books. I want it to be solved, but it's seemingly more and more unlikely each day. D.B. Cooper. Something people don't realize either is that D.B. Cooper landed in the area where Mountain Street, Helens erupted. If there was any physical evidence, including his remains, they could very well have been destroyed 9 years after the hijacking. You bring up a very valid point. The best clue they ever found was when that kid found part of the money. I always wondered why they couldn't trace its trail back to more money. But then you realize the eruption happened a little over 1 month after that find. Yeah, all of that area was damaged beyond recognition. I went there a few times as a kid 96 and the damage was still there, but they replanted a lot of trees. Haven't been there since, so I can't tell you what the place looks like right now. Whether Frank Morris, John Anglin, and his brother Clarence Anglin survived their escape from Alcatraz Federal Prison. Some Dutch scientists tried it with a decimal ago that of the escape. Weather, water patterns, etc. Same style of raft and so on. They got very close, but said if we had an adrenaline rush of escaping prison and becoming free, then we'd probably would have gotten to the coast. If Jamie and Adam from Mythbusters can make it, anyone can. The fate of the Mary Celeste's crew. This seems plausible. Link. The real identity of Jack the Ripper. Twas Laszlo Kravenswarth. Fuida Kinguhai. Nanda is why I'll be calling it creepy paper until I die. What happened to the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum paintings? The sheer audacity of those two men who pulled off that heist is impressive. The museum still offers a 10 million reward for info leading to finding the pieces and the culprits. One of Australia's prime ministers just disappeared when he went for a swim in the ocean. So probably that. Where the Sumerians came from. It's fascinating how the first people to invent writing and settle in great cities Eridu, Uruk, speak a language totally unrelated to the languages of the people around them who spoke Semitic languages. A theory says they emerged out of the Ubaid culture and were indigenous to Mesopotamia, while another goes so far as to claim they came from the area of the Persian Gulf before it was flooded at the end of the last ice age. Some others believe they are related to the Indus Valley civilization, which they supposedly called Miluha. I agree, it's an interesting problem, but it's also kind of what you'd expect. Most of the languages of that region were simply never recorded. It could have been an isolate at the time writing was being innovated. Or it could have been part of a larger family with relatives in India or Africa. We aren't going to know, because only the speakers in this one region were using that system, until it was adapted for language families centuries later, like Akkadian or Hittite. And it's not like language isolates are truly isolate. All languages come from other languages. Go far enough back, and Sumerian and Proto-Afro-Asiatic could have had a common source, okay. Probably not that particular pair, but you get the idea. Elamite's another isolate from the period. But it could easily have a distant relationship to Dravidian or Caucasian families or something. And if it didn't, then it has a relationship with unknown languages. The Semitic speakers who conquered and integrated Sumer were themselves far removed from their language family's original homeland. What's more, their branch of Semitic, Eastern, is extinct. Sumerian's relatives could have just become extinct at a time before it was possible to record them. However, I do think it most likely that Sumerians were not indigenous to that delta. Their mythohistorical accounts of having traveled from a southern land notwithstanding, they appear to have had a different skin tone to their immediate neighbors. Linguistically, there is still much we don't know, but the large amount of homonyms suggests a tonal or pitch accented system, which would also be innovative for the region. But, in case this is a reason for anyone's interest, I would stress that there is more than sufficient evidence that they innovated writing there, rather than having brought it with them from elsewhere. We have a good 5-6 centuries of proto-writing from them, and can trace the origin of many cuneiform signs to pictographs on coins and tokens. A relationship with the Harappan civilization is non-existent. In my view, Indus Valley writing is proto-writing, and shares none of the characteristics of Sumerian proto-writing. A related mystery I'm keen on is whether writing was culturally diffused from Sumer to Egypt, or whether they were independent innovations. They are certainly independent systems, but they could have been a related or interdependent innovation early in the proto-writing stage that allowed their independent development, and they seem like neighbors. But there's no evidence of trade between them at this stage, and people didn't travel that far without good reason. The identity of the Eastal woman link. I'm currently obsessed with reading about the Tulland man. Yes, evidently he was a human sacrifice, but his insanely well-preserved face looks so happy and at peace. When the Tulland man was found, the local police felt sure that it was the results of a fairly recent murder. They were off by a few years. Mystery of the Somerton Man, also known as the Tamim Shud case. The disappearance of the Lake Fame nomadic people that predated the pharaohs. They had no writing, no records of any form, and lived solely near the banks of the Nile and an ancient lake. They had a community for a long time that included bakeries, agriculture, weaving, and some precursor to religious or artistic element. One day, the people vanished. They left their fish in the cooking pots, dry food stored under the floorboards of their houses, and pottery still on the wheel. It was like they were picked up and carried away, or the people suddenly left in a hurry and left everything behind. Then shortly after, the material culture of early pre-pharaonic Egyptian kingdoms arose. Some believe the Fame people migrated north to become the early Egyptians because of unusually arid conditions. Others say they were killed or captured, but there were no signs of struggle. They possessed and left no weapons. And that doesn't explain why the people left their entire culture intact. Could it be something like Lake Nias link? In which case there's been no human remains after so many millennia, but the objects of their material culture would remain. Part of me wants to take this and the above post and make a fantasy novel about a vanished culture. The other part wants to do the same, but run it as a creeped campaign. The Missing Men of Bermagui, NSW, Australia. 5 men disappeared in the 19th century, completely vanished off the face of the planet, with some very confusing things left behind. I'm tempted to do a YouTube video on it sometime, because so few people know this story, yet it's such a baffling one. Where Attila the Hun is buried. Him and Genghis Khan are unlikely to ever be found. Nomadic tribes didn't exactly mark burial places. That damn Amber Room. Once you really look into everything that is known about the murder of Lizzie Borden's father and stepmother, you sort of have to accept the fact that, unless we straight up find a written confession 130 years later, we have no idea what the heck happened. It didn't help that the police were literally at a fair that day, so most of the squad didn't show up. The doctor on the scene pumped Lizzie full of morphine to help with her hysterics, so nothing she said at the time is of any use. The coroner let the bodies just sit for over 5 days unrefrigerated, and the time frame of the event simultaneously seemed to confirm 2 things. 1, nobody from outside of the house could have walked in, killed 2 people, and walk out absolutely soaked in blood without being seen by multiple people. 2, nobody who was on the property could have killed 2 people and completely dispose of the evidence before the police and doctor arrived. It's not the cut and dry case people think it was. It's an enormous mess. My neighbor killed his whole family, buried them in his house, then went for a trip. Nobody knows if he's dead or hiding somewhere, and if so, where. The police kind of screwed up the start of the investigation, so he had a good head start on them. His name is, or maybe was, Xavier Dupont de Ligonslink, and he was, since then, featured in multiple TV shows and books. The Bronze Age Collapse. Where'd they all go? All my homies. Most serial killer cases. Unfortunately, shows portray cold cases as being more of interest to investigators when they aren't. D.B. Cooper, Jack the Ripped, Madeline McCann, etc. are likely going to be unsolved for most of time. Jack the Ripped gave me a chuckle. Is that part of your theory? He had massive muscles. Search the gyms. What happened to the princes in the tower? The meaning of the text in the Voynich manuscript. Also, deciphering the Rango Rango texts of rapper NUI Easter Island. Genuine question: how do we know that there is any genuine meaning to the Voynich manuscript? Like, how do we know it isn't some elaborate 15th century art project? The missing minutes of the Watergate tapes. What happened during that time? That's a good one. Because given that plenty of incredibly damning stuff did come out, it either has to be an innocent mistake or something really bad. The Sea Peoples. A group of people show up randomly just in time to see the Bronze Age collapse and then duck off and are never heard from again. Where did they come from? Where did they go? Where did they come from? Cotton-eyed Joe. My money's on the sea. Einstein's last words. Nobody knows what they were because the nurse taking care of him didn't speak German. Big lack of foresight there, lol. John Bennett Ramsey. The various dancing plagues between 1374-1518. Link. Also, why the universe is expanding faster than it should. B. Link. I'm going to go in a much different direction and say what the origin of language was like. We obviously don't know anything that isn't written down. And relatively speaking, that time period is quite recent. We can probably get an estimation of which points grunts became words just by looking at biology, if we are lucky enough to have a well-preserved specimen. But we'll never know what the first full set of words sounded like. It's not a huge mystery, but I'd be fascinated what the liberation of Auschwitz did to the mental health of the Soviet soldiers who liberated it. I've seen some stuff on Americans who liberated much smaller camps, but just the thought of what it must have done to discover the biggest one. Who has in their possession the Ark of the Covenant? Ethiopians or the Vatican? One of the two. Who put Bella in the witch elm? What works were lost from the Library of Alexandria? The Grand Unified Field Theory. The disappearance of MH370. Even if they do find the plane, or what's left of it, it's been so long that the black box won't be any use to anybody, so we will never really know for sure what happened. Why Henry VIII was so mad. He thought of himself as the perfect medieval prince, but he was not an absolute monarch like his French rival. He was rich, but not as rich as his nephew Charles V. He wasn't as successful in war as his Henry V. In short, despite being a 6-foot-plus athletically tall king, he was always second best. He struggled to produce an heir, which threatened to plunge the country back into civil war and end his fledgling dynasty before it got off the ground. He was the spare as well. His older brother died, so he wasn't even first there either. Then on top of that, he was likely brain damaged in jousting accident. We could go deeper, but that seems enough to be getting on with. Where the heck these extra Tupperwillids come from? Meanwhile, in a parallel dimension, where the heck these Tupperwillids disappearing to? The girl in the polka dot dress. At this point, I feel like the Delphi murders will never be solved, even if the scene was contaminated and not properly investigated. I truly believe that the real story is interwoven with some serious seedy shit involving Lee and other agencies. Everyone be lurking this thread secretly wishing someone posted a mystery that's actually been solved. Spring-heeled Jack. The Holy Grail. Where the Jesus Tombies. Who's Julius Caesar's son is? Rasputin. Even if he took the king's son off his aspirin to help his hemophilia, how did he know to do that? How did he even get so close with the royal family without anyone raising an eyebrow until it became completely public? Did Tsar Nicholas's advisors see nothing wrong with a homeless wizard being associated with the Tsar? How did he really die, or how did he live the shot in poison, if that story's true? Just so many questions lost to time.